for them to also review and enforce all of the things that the defense and the prosecution said in this case in their closing and opening argument. We also know that the jury did ask some questions, so they are taking this job very seriously. They have asked for jury instructions, and they wanted copies of those jury instructions. First, the first few pages, and then they basically said, just give us 11 copies of all 36 pages of jury instructions. And that may be in part because when the judge was giving those instructions, it became very confusing to the average person. We're all listening to it, wondering what's going on. So the jury wanted to see it down on paper, each of them being able to look at it very closely to see how they could apply the law to the evidence that they actually listened to throughout this trial. Then,
what about the atmosphere? And what is it like as everyone awaits this verdict? So
it's very different than it was this summer. You do have a few, usually not more than about a couple of dozen protesters, if that, who come to the court on a regular basis, including Jacob Blake's uncle. And as you will remember, that the protesters, as in some cases turned to riots, were here because of the shooting of Jacob Blake by a police officer who was never charged in that case. So his uncle does come out. He comes out with a few people. There are others that join. There are some folks that are here that are in support of Kyle Rittenhouse and want him to be considered not guilty by this jury. And there are other folks who want to see guilt. There's a lot of talk about the trial outside the court. And at times, I was in the courtroom this morning, you can hear the protesting inside the courtroom. It's very low, but you can hear some of the folks who are on megaphones in the court. But the jury has been, you know, sort of out of the courtroom for all day today, basically, until it was time for them to be told that they can go home. And they are not being sequestered. We can also tell you the jury consists of 7 women and 5 men, all of them Caucasian except for one person of color. This will be an interesting case for them to go through because there is quite a bit of evidence for them to really parse through. No one knows just how long it's going to take this jury to decide whether or not they think Kyle Rittenhouse is guilty in this case.
All right, Sarah Seidman, Sarah, thank you very much. Appreciate that. Meanwhile, in Washington, there is news tonight on the January 6th investigation. More speed is coming this week, which has got to be making Team Trump wonder who's next. 35 of them have already been submitted. The committee telling CNN they're considering their options.